Good morning, children. In the last class, we studied about compound and mixtures and the differences between compound and mixture. Okay, using activities, we can differentiate that compound and mixtures. Okay, now we are going to see about what are the classification of mixtures. Okay, mixture are classified into two. One is homogeneous mixtures and another one is heterogeneous mixtures. Okay, homo means one. Okay, one. So homogeneous mixture means it has to be seen as a one uniform composition. Okay, hetero means more than one. Okay, then homogeneous mixture. For this homogeneous mixture, you can imagine salt and water mixture, salt and water mixture. For heterogeneous mixture, you imagine sand and water. Okay, imagine that. Then homogeneous mixture means in salt and water means the components cannot be separated. That is, in a salt and water mixture means you cannot separate it. This is salt, salt, and this is water molecules. Okay, you can't separate that. So in homogeneous mixtures, the components cannot be separated. Okay, and it seems to be uniform composition. Seems to be uniform composition. Okay, then every part has the same property. Salt and water, water molecules, all are have same property. For this homogeneous mixture, salt solution, sugar syrup, these are the examples for this homogeneous mixture. Then come to heterogeneous mixture. What is the example I given? Sand and water solution. So when you are seeing that mixture means you can find out this is sand and this is water. Okay, so heterogeneous means its component can be seen through your naked eye. You can see the components. This is sand component and this is water. You can see. So the first property is the components can be seen through your eye. Okay, then no uniform composition. You can differentiate the mixture. Up to this sand is there, and from this sand and water are differentiated. Okay, so no uniform composition. The third one, you can differentiate the property of sands and water. Okay, so these are the properties of heterogeneous mixtures. So the components can be seen, no uniform composition, different property. You can differentiate the property. Okay, R example, R is an example for a heterogeneous mixture, because R contains carbon dioxide, nitrogen, water vapor, all are mixed together in air. Okay, so air is a mixture. Then soil. Okay, these are the examples for heterogeneous mixtures. Ma, thank you.